Good morning, Crocker House Camp!
Good morning, Miss Caitlin!
It is Wednesday, June 17th, and I'm so glad you joined us this morning. We are going to start with a little vocal warm-up, so take a deep breath and sigh. And say bumblebee.
Bumblebee.
We're going to start down low. Ready? Bumblebee, 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 bumblebee. Now very staccato. Bumblebee, 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 bumblebee. Now very long and connected.
Bumblebee, 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 bumblebee.
Very good. Now stick out your right hand and shake it 10 times.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Left foot.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Left hand.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Right foot.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Shake it all over, shake it out, shake it over. And repeat after me. Thumbs up.
Thumbs up.
Wrists together.
Wrists together.
And
arustasha, arustasha, arustasha.
Thumbs up.
Thumbs up.
Wrists together.
Wrists together.
Elbows together.
Elbows together.
Chest out.
Chest out.
And
arustasha. 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 Arustasha.
Thumbs up.
Thumbs up.
Wrists together.
Wrists together.
Elbows together.
Elbows together.
Chest out.
Chest out.
Booty out.
Booty out.
And
arustasha. Arustasha. Arustasha.
Over here. And hey, Maddie!
Hey, what?
Do your thing!
I can't!
Why not?
I just can't!
Why not?
Because my knees are shaky and my belt's too tight and my hips keep swaying from the left to the right!
From the left to the right, from the left to the right, from the left, right, left, right. Reese's Pieces, peanut butter, bang, bang, choo choo train, come on! Why not?
I just can't.
Why not?
Well, because my knees are shaking and my belt is too tight and my hips just keep swaying from the left to the right.
To the left, to the right. From the left, to the right. From the left, right, left, right. Reese's Pieces, peanut butter, bang, bang, choo-choo train. Come on,
Aubrey.
Do your thing.
I just can't.
Why not?
I just can't.
Why not?
Because my knees are shaking and my belt's too tight and my hips are swaying from the left to the right.
From the left to the right. From the left to the right. the left, right, left, right. Reese's Pieces, peanut butter, bang, bang, choo-choo train. Come on,
Aiden,
do your thing.
I can't.
Why not?
I just can't.
Why not?
Because my knees are shaking, my belt's way too tight, my hips keep swaying from the left to the right.
From the left to the right. From the left to the right. From the left, right, left, right. Reese's Pieces, peanut butter, bang, bang, choo-choo train. Come on,
Emily.
Do your thing.
I can't.
Why not?
I just can't.
Why not?
Because my knees are shaking and my belt is too tight and my hips keep swaying from the left to the right.
From the left to the right. From the left to the right. From the left, right, left, right. Reese's Pieces, peanut butter, bang, bang, choo-choo train. Come on.
Brenna.
Do your thing.
I can't.
Why not?
I just really can't.
Why not?
Because my knees, they be shaking and my belt too tight and my hips. They swayed from the left to the right.
From the left to the right. From the left to the right. From the left, right, left, right. Reese's Pieces, peanut butter, bang, bang, choo-choo train.
All right. We are going to sing some Bright and Early Morning. And it starts off with One Bright and Early Morning. Actually, we'll do a call and repeat for this one. Ready? One bright and early morning, I walk the forest through.
One bright and early morning, I walk the forest through.
And suddenly I heard a soft and low cuckoo.
And suddenly I heard a soft and low cuckoo. Cuckoo, 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 cuckoo.
All together.
One bright and early morning, I walked the forest through, and suddenly I heard a soft and low cuckoo. Cuckoo, 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 cuckoo. One bright and early morning, I walked the forest through, and suddenly I heard a soft and low cuckoo.
Very good. All right, we need some kookaburra sits in the old gum tree. Ready? The
kookaburra sits in the old gum tree. Merry, merry king of the bush is he. Laugh, kookaburra, laugh. Kookaburra gay, your life must be. Kookaburra sits in the old gum tree, eating all the gumdrops he can see. Stop, kookaburra, stop. Kookaburra, save some gum for me. Kookaburra sits in the old gum tree, hugging all the monkeys he can see. Stop, kookaburra, stop. Kookaburra, that's not a monkey, that's me.
All right, good job. All right. That's it for us for today. Stay tuned for your next lesson. Woo!
Hey guys, I'm back again. Thought it'd be fun to show you a couple of really basic dance steps so that you could create your own dances at home for fun. If you create your own dances at home, be sure to send them, email them into Cocker House so that we can watch you guys do your thing. So, first thing we're going to do is I'm going to start by explaining the axial. So your axial is your center line through your body. So imagine that you have a string that goes to the top of your head all the way down to your feet, and that is your center line. And we can do lots of things. We can cross our axial, we can bend it. So let's try bending forward. So we're bending our axial. Now we're straightening our axial. Now we're crossing, so we're gonna take an arm over like that. You can cross, you can twist, do anything you want. You can cross with your leg, cross, you can bend it over like that. Bend it over like that. So have fun, do lots of things, moving your axial all around. Next step I want to show you is called a grapevine. So I'm gonna step back a little bit, do a grapevine. So you keep your feet in a parallel first position. So you're going to step with your right foot, step behind with your left foot, step with your right foot, so you should be back in that first position. and I hope I don't get out of frame. But you're gonna step with your left foot again and right foot. So let's go the opposite. So we're gonna step with our left, go behind with our right, step with our left, go behind with our right. So that's a great vibe. So you can use those in your dance moves, change it up a bit, make it fun, make it exciting. Next is called a swivel step. So you're gonna be in your parallel first position. You're gonna step forward with your right foot, and then you're just gonna swivel and do a little turn. So that's a fun way to turn. Just do a little switcheroos like that. Next is step, hop, step, hop. So you can step, hop, step, hop. You can do step, hop, step, hop. And you can do fun like little twists with your hop if you want. Make it fun, make it you. So I'm gonna show you how to do a really basic turn. So what you wanna do is you want to put your feet, if you watched our dance video, you put your feet into a fourth position. So you're gonna put your foot out, have it like that. Make sure you have your ballet hands. Make sure you're squeezing your tummy muscles so your back is nice and straight. You're gonna put your arm out, and then this arm is what you use to propel yourself. So when you go up and you put your leg up right here with your knee, go back. When you go up, make sure you use this arm to propel yourself. And that is how you do a spin. Make sure that you spot, so pick a point on the wall, so that when you go up, your head immediately turns back to that one spot so you don't get dizzy. The last step I'm going to show you is called a box step. So for a box step, we want to start with our feet parallel, straight ahead of us. So we're going to take a step with your right foot, step up with your left, cross over with your right, step back with your left, step back with your right, back to your first position. So up, up, over, back, back. So let's do it again. Step up, step up, over, back, back. And that's a box step.
Can you turn that, or can you turn around and show us how to do that? Sometimes
yeah.
That one's easy to see from behind.
All right, so I'm gonna do from this angle. So you're gonna step up, cross over, step back, so we'll do one more time. You're gonna step up, cross over, step back,
alright,
do a little swivel turn. So you can use those in any kind of different combination. Feel free to have fun. If you do make a video that you want to send to us, be sure to send it to us, because we'd love to see what you do. So have fun, be safe, enjoy.
Hi guys, welcome back to singing. This is our second lesson. Today we'll be going a little bit, reviewing a little bit of what we learned in the first lesson. And then we're going to learn the second part to a couple of songs and also the beginning of another song. And but first, make sure that you have proper singing stance. So hopefully you're able to stand up and with your feet shoulder width apart. And your knees should not be locked like a soldier, but a little bit relaxed to allow some blood flow to your brain. And if you're seated, you want to sit up nice and straight, and so that you're not crunching your tummy muscles or crunching your lungs, right? They need lots of room. So our back is nice and strong, our shoulders are back and relaxed, our chin is parallel to the floor, and so this is the tallest part of us, right? And we are going to take a nice big breath. Feel those lungs expand to the side and to the front and to the back. And just sigh. We're going to kind of connect that diaphragm support to our breath. So pant like a dog. Really get that voice awake. And let's do a little, we're going to do a little bit of a roller coaster. So we're going to start down low, then go up a little bit and back down, a little bit higher and back down, and then really high.
without screaming. Screaming's not good for your vocal cords. So, nice big breath. Very good. And let's do some, we're gonna do a couple of warm-ups here. And let's send it way far into our nose, saying la 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 la, and then really far back, say a loo 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 loo, our very throaty sound, and in our chest voice say la 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 la, and up in our head voice say lee. Very good. And let's do some warm ups here. We're going to do. La 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 la, just like that. La 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 la, and a lee, lee 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 lee, and a low, low 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 low, and a loo, loo 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 loo, and a la, la la. My tongue and the roof of my mouth. I
rich or rounded or full of a sound, right? So we try to keep lots of space. Now, let's do one more warm-up. We're going to do a bumblebee. So we really are enunciating the B's in the word bumblebee, and we're having a nice tall bumble, having that nice tall in our bumblebee. Let's start here. Bumblebee, 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 a little faster. Bumblebee, 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 bumblebee. Now if we didn't use our vowels, and it would be all the consonants, the M's and the B's, bumblebee, bumblebee, right? Which is a good way to practice too, but we really like to focus on those vowels. All right, take one more big breath, and we're just gonna sigh. And let's get our mouth a little more warmed up. Let's try some tongue twisters. So we'll start with a simple one. Say, toy boat, toy boat. Now say it three times fast. Toy boat, toy boat, toy boat. And see if you can get even faster. Toy boat, toy boat, toy boat. Good job. All right, now try Irish wrist watch and really aim for that wrist watch. Get that T in there, wrist. Irish wrist watch. Now try it three times fast. Irish wrist watch, 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 Irish wrist watch. Very good. Now make it a little harder. Irish wrist watch, Swiss wrist watch. Pretty hard, isn't it? Try it again. Irish wristwatch, Swiss wristwatch. Very good. That one takes practice for sure. And the other, let's see, one more tongue twister. The skunk sat on a stump. The stump said the skunk stunk. The skunk said the stump stunk. There you go. Now put it all together. The skunk sat on a stump. The stump said the skunk stunk. The skunk said the stump stunk. It's kind of hard, but really aiming for those P's, stump and skunk, those hard K sounds, really gets all the different parts of our tongue and our lips and our teeth warmed up. Good job. All right, now I want to go over the first part of the Do Na Nobis Pacem that we already learned. So let's sing through that part. Ready? Really big, tall vowels. Do Na Nobis Pacem, Pacem. Do Na Nobis Pacem. Very good, you remembered. Okay, now I'm going to teach you the second part. So we ended on this note, Cem, and now we're going to jump up to here. Ready? So it goes, Do Na Nobis.
Now you're going to try that with just the piano. I'm not going to sing this time. Ready?
Helps to think we're sleeping underneath the same big sky. Let's do that part. It helps to think we're sleeping underneath the same big sky. Very good. So let's put those two parts together. And when the night wind starts to sing. And when the night wind starts to sing a lonesome lullaby, it helps to think we're sleeping underneath the same big sky. Very good. So now we'll put those two parts together. From the end, even though I know how very far apart we are.
And even though I know how very far apart we are, it helps to think we might be wishing on the same bright star. And when the night wind starts to sing a lonesome lullaby, it helps to think we're sleeping underneath the same big sky.
Very good. Let's do that again, and I'll sing the low part this time.
And even though I know how very far apart we are, it helps to think we might be wishing on the same bright star. And when the night wind starts to sing a lonesome lullaby, it helps to think we're sleeping underneath the same big sky.
Very good. All right, we're going to put those two together from the very first page. And let me get this a little arranged here. There we go. So we're going to start at the very beginning. All right. Here we go.
Somewhere out there, beneath the blue light, someone's thinking of me and loving me tonight. Somewhere out there, someone's saying a prayer. Loving me tonight.
Have a fabulous time at story time or your next lesson, and I will see you for our third lesson very soon.
All right, hey guys, welcome to another really cool craft for today. We are gonna be making some really cool kites. I'm Meg, again, one of the craft people, and we're gonna be making these diamond-shaped kites with tails that you can tie a string on and also fly like the bird kites. And so there's a couple different ways to do these, different variations, and we're gonna show you. So you're going to need a piece of construction paper. You're going to need a dowel, two popsicle sticks, some tape or some glue. We're gonna use tape when I do this demonstration. You're gonna need ribbon or yarn or string, something fun to decorate to do a tail with. And then you're gonna need some regular string to hold onto it with. And then scissors, and then a straight edge. So we're gonna use a ruler, but you could even use the dowel that comes with it, maybe. Or anything else. A book, make sure to ask that you can use the book. Don't draw on the book. But you can use a book. Anything that has a straight edge will work really well. So with this one, what we're going to do is we are going to take the piece of paper, and if you see on this one is glued, and so we used the popsicle sticks across, and we glued those down first, and then we glued the dowel over them. But what we're going to do with this one is a little bit different. We're going to use tape because that's a little easier, so if you want it to be a little bit easier, that's an easy way to do it. So you're going to put the dowel down, and you're going to try and find the middle. Doesn't have to be perfect. If you really want, you can ask for help, or you can fold your paper over to find the middle, right? Because if you fold it like this and line up the edges, you can find the middle that way. But I'm just going to kind of eyeball it because I can do that. And I'm just going to tape that down right away. Super easy. I'm going to do one piece at the top. Oh, maybe a little bit bigger pieces of tape so that they stay. So probably about this long, just to make sure that they stay. They don't have to be that long, but you can if you want to. One at the bottom. Smooth it out. And then one not at the top here, but kind of in the middle, like this. And then your dowel is down on the paper. And then you can use your popsicle sticks. And this way, you can line them up pretty well, right? And so you can put them however far down you want. You want them to be in the top half, right up here. Probably about a third of the way down the whole dowel. So this is half, and these would be thirds. So about that far. And then again, you're just gonna tape it. And I would use two pieces of tape for each popsicle stick, just to make sure that they stay on there and they don't fall off. And again, if you're gluing it, you can do the same thing. You can put the dowel on first and glue it like this, or you can do what I did with this one and glue both the popsicle sticks down on top of each other and then glue the dowel down. And if you do that, what I would do is glue the popsicle sticks, put the glue on them, and then for the dowel, put the glue on the paper in kind of a straight line and put some at the bottom and some at the top because it won't stick the whole way, and then hold it for about 30 seconds, but you're gonna have to let it dry. You have to wait for it to dry after those 30 seconds. So you're gonna tape your popsicle sticks if you're taping. A little bit longer, there we go. All right, got it all taped down, awesome. That's like the hardest part. So next what you're going to do is you're gonna use your straight edge, whatever you decided to do that for, and you're going to trace in between each point so that you can cut out the diamond shape, because this makes it way easier to cut out. So I am going to put my straight edge like this, take my pen or pencil, whatever you want to use, and you're going to start at any side and just draw kind of a line, and it's okay. You're probably going to go over the tape at a couple places. That's totally fine. Because what you can do is just cut through it, and it's not going to matter because there's still tape all over. So I'm going to put it there, and right here. And if you don't use a straight edge, if it's not perfectly straight, that's okay too. It's still going to fly. You're still going to have a great time. It's still going to look really cool, I promise. And then you're going to draw this one like this. And then your last side. All right, now that you have it all drawn, you can put your pen or pencil away for now. And you're gonna take your scissors, and you're just gonna cut along the lines. Super easy. Again, you can cut through the tape because there's still tape there that's keeping it all together. So, you cut like this. And you don't have to cut super perfectly against the line. The line is a guide for you. So see right here, I'm a little bit off. That's perfectly fine. Got one. Dropping my paper on the floor. Got your next side. And then cut out this one. And your last side. All right, look at that. We've got our kite. Got the kite shape, which is awesome. Most of the hard part's done. Super easy. So now what you can do, like on this one, you can decorate it. You can decorate it anytime you want. I drew some kind of polka dot things. You can draw whatever you want. You could use glitter, whatever makes you happy. Decorate your kite. And so the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna give it a tail. So you can see on this one, I'm gonna use this one since I already did it. It's really easy. Again, you just tape it. Just tape it on. Take your piece of ribbon, a piece of yarn, whatever it is, a length, maybe about the length of your arm, and put it on the end of the kite. Tape one end here. Make sure it stays on. Maybe tape over the dowel. And then what we're gonna do is you can use fabric, you can use more ribbon, you can use more yarn, and we're gonna do these little ties here that kind of give it, you know, give it some character, make it fun. So I dropped my other tie, but here it is. All right, so again, it's super easy, super simple knot. I'm gonna do three at the end. It's just like tying your shoes, that sort of knot. You only need the one because it will stay, I promise. Maybe, hold on. All right, and then you just tie it on, tie it super tight. And then there you go, look at that. You've got a really cool tail for your kite, and the last thing you need is the string, obviously. So again, you would use a piece longer than this because you want it to fly, so maybe two times this length, and you're just going to take it and tie it kind of up here near the cross. So pull it underneath. You might have to pull the dowel up a little bit, but it will come up, I promise. Pull it underneath, tie a knot, again just the same knot you use to tie your shoes. And this one, we want to double knot to make sure that it stays on because the string or whatever you're using is a little bit more likely to slip off. So just do a quick double knot. Super simple. And now you're ready to go. You have your kite. It's got a tail. It's decorated. It's all tied and you are ready to go. Just hold on to the end and run around and it will fly. I promise. It's going to be super fun. Have fun.
Welcome back to another day of storytelling. Today, I want to tell you the story of Rindasella. I'm pretty sure you know this story about the little girl who lives with the mad bisters and the ugly mother. The muggly other, right? The muggly other and the sad bisters. Yes, that story. Well, as you probably remember, there was a girl named Rindasella, and what she wanted more than anything else was to go to a fancy ball and meet the prancing hens. But all she had to wear were wordy bags. Well, one night, the prancing hens, he sent out a message to all of the girls in the kingdom and said, "You may come to my fancy fall." And everyone at the house was so excited. "Oh, we get to go to a fancy fall, and we're going to wear fancy dressy fences. It's going to be so wonderful, and we're going to meet the prancing hens, and we will dance all night. Nance all night. We will dance all night." And then the muggly other said, "You don't get to go to a fancy fall. Look at you. All you have to wear are rudy dags. We are going, and you will stay home." Well, Rindasella just sat down and cried. It wasn't fair. That's when the hairy fodgather showed up and said, "Why are you crying?" She said, "I wanted to go to the fancy fall and meet the prancing hens, but all I have are rudy dags." And the muggly fodgather said, "I will wave my magic wand, and I will give you a beautiful gown." And he did, and suddenly she was in a beautiful gown. And she said, "But this is wonderful, but I don't have a way to get there." So he took a magic mumpkin, and he waved his magic wand, and suddenly it was a beautiful boat. She said, "Oh, I'm ready to go, but I'm
ugly Fodgother waved the magic wand again, and suddenly she was wearing Splass Glippers. Well, off she went in the Pageant Mumpkin off to the Bansy Fall. When she got there, she didn't know that the Prancing Hinz was watching her behind a wooden window. He saw the beautiful girl, and he said, "That is the beautiful girl that I wish to manse with all dight." And they did manse all dight. But suddenly, it was Nidmite! Winterstella said, "Oh no, I have to go!" And she ran out of the castle, but she slopped her dripper! The Prancing Hinz found the slop dripper and said, "I will marry no one but the beautiful girl who wears this slop stripper." The next day, went off all through the palace. There was Wintercella's house. When the prince got there, she was so excited. The Prancing Hinz was there. She looked at herself and thought, "I can't introduce myself to the Prancing Hinz." But the muggly other could. "Hello, prince." The Prancing Hinz came in and he tried on the slop dripper, but it didn't it. She said, "Hey, we'll try it on the muggly others." Not the muggly others, the sad bisters. The sad bisters each put their foot in, but it didn't it. Then Wintercella peeked out and saw the Prancing Hinz, and he said, "That beautiful girl there, bring her forward." And she came forward and she took out her foot and slid it inside, and it fit it. Suddenly she was out of her rudy dags and in a beautiful bound, and the Prancing Hinz said, "It is you." And she said, "It's me." And then they lived happily ever after. And the sorrel of the Mori is this: if you ever want to meet a Prancing Hinz at a Bansy Fall, be sure to slop your dripper. Okay, love bugs, today is your third day of your creative task. Hopefully you've gone and made a fort and it's turning out to be pretty cool. Hopefully yesterday you paid attention to your senses. And today I would like to challenge you to go and find all the art supplies that live in your house. I am pretty sure, now don't go after your mom's or your dad's private collection of art supplies, but I'm pretty sure you have crayons, scissors, tape, glue, construction paper, toilet paper rolls, confetti. I bet there's a drawer in your room where all this stuff has gone. Play-Doh, clay, puzzles. I think you probably have a place in the toy box, if you start digging through there, of all kinds of things that your grandma gave you. It was a design kit or a spirograph or a thing that you were supposed to use with pens or a poster you were supposed to color or a blacklight poster. I don't know. There's so many things that you have that end up where you go, "Oh, cool, fun." You play with it and you put it away. And I'm challenging you today for your creative task to go look. Now ask your mom, ask your dad, ask your big sister or your babysitter, is it okay if you go looking for art supplies? Tell them what you're looking for. I think you're going to be able to find watercolors, because you always get a tray of watercolors with coloring books sometimes and they end up in a drawer somewhere. So watercolors, how about some paint brushes? Scissors are good, but don't take your mom's. Make sure that you get some scissors that are good to use. I personally like to have my own Scotch tape, and I prefer when someone asks me if they can borrow my Scotch tape, so be sure you ask if you can borrow Scotch tape. Maybe you could have your own roll. Ask if you can have your own roll if there's some. I know pens are around, like you have colored markers and different kinds, and probably you need to sit down and go through it and look through them, which ones still have color in them, which ones don't, which ones should go to the trash. So my challenge for you today is to gather your creative art supplies. I would like to see them all gathered, cleaned, organized by you, and so that you know what you have available and what you might need if you are going to make a piece of art. All right, have fun gathering all that stuff together. Bye.